Let's start writing the code for this game. Go to the properties panel and let's create a new base class for this game. So the class name is maze game, and let's save this ActionScript file as in that mazegame.as. Let us include the library files on the top which are required for this game. So we're just including the flash.events.event, flash.events.keyboardevent, because we are going to use that arrow keys to move the smiley, then we require keyboard events. And let us include even that UI.keyboard, because to recognize the key codes. Alright, let's get into the public class. We just want 4 different variables to identify the key down events. So I'm just declaring that 4 variables. They are mouse up, mouse down, mouse left and mouse right. These are the variable names, and each variable data type is boolean, and the default value of that each variable is false. We are going to make them true when I press the key. When I release the key again, that we will get them back to false. So these are the 4 variables here, and let's declare one more variable to control the speed of the smiley. So I would like to name it as in speed, and the data type of that variable is number, and the constant value is 5. Let's add event listeners for keyboard events, which is supposed to be stage.addEventListener, keyboardEvent.keyDown, and let's apply the function name. Similarly, that we are supposed to take another event listener for key up, and then we need to define the function name for it even. Add event listener, and then keyboard event dot key up, comma function name. So the 2 key events and functions. Let us declare these 2 functions here out of the public function. We need to define them as in private function. Private function and function name, and type of that event is keyboard event, and let's type something inside this function. Now I just want to include a small condition here to check which key is pressing. When we press the key, that it will generate a key code. Based on that key code value, that it is possible for us to identify the key. We are having the different key codes for it and key names also. So let us use that key names here in this if condition. So we could see here, if e.keycode is double equal to key up, then mouse up is true. Similarly, let's take that same condition and copy paste for 4 times to check other 3 keys. So I'm just changing that key names, and vice versa, that I am updating that variable value as in true. Mouse up, mouse down, mouse left, mouse right. Depends upon that key name, we can update that particular variable value as in true. So we see that 4 if conditions there, and let's save the file now. And we're supposed to define another function even, which is supposed to be false again. When I press the key, then boolean variable value must be true, and then when I release the key, the same boolean variable value is supposed to get back to that original value, which is false. Let's define the function and same condition. Let's take that same 4 conditions, I copy and paste it here, and based on that same condition would be remain same, and but variable value must pick up false, must be false. Same conditions, but 2 different events. Let's save the file and let us define one more function here. I just wanted to define that function for enter frame event. Enter frame is the event that which will help us to execute it continuously. Then let us define this function. Based on that variable value, I just wanted to update the position of the object which is Miley here. Let us write a simple small if condition. If mouse up is double equal to true, so when this variable will be value will be true when I press the up arrow. So that's how I can check the condition and I can update Y position of the Miley. I can say mouse up is double equal to true, then player dot y is equals to minus speed, minus equals to speed. So we can see here, we just tested it. I could see that my Miley is moving up. Let's say take the same condition, copy paste another three times. We just need to update the variable names and the axis value. So if it is mouse down, then y must be plus, y equal to plus, y plus equal to speed. We can see my object is moving up and down now. Let's add one more if condition, and we just need to update the variable name and the axis even. Mouse left and axis must be x, and of course minus value. Let's paste the condition once again, and variable name must be mouse right, and of course that we are supposed to update that x value. Now it is supposed to be plus. Let us save and test the movie. All right, I can see that my object moving up and down, left and right. Depends upon that arrow keys that my object will move in that particular direction. Now, we just need to include a condition to check the hit point of the line. So it is not supposed to cross the line. It is not supposed to cross the line. So for that, we can use hit test point. We have an hit test object, but we don't want to check the test object. We want to check with that hit test point, which will be executed based upon the target object x and y position. Not mazemc.hitTestPoint of player x and player y. So then it is supposed to move. I'm just taking that, you know, the opposite condition there. Generally we check with maze dot hit test point, but here in this case that we are taking not of maze mc dot hit test point, but still that my object is crossing that line. The reason why, the step value is five points. Whenever I press the key, that it is jumping for 5 pixels, but here the stroke value is only 2 points, which will not be considerable. So I'm just increasing that stroke weight here, and let's go back and save, execute it. Right, now that we can see here, when Miley is hitting that center point, it is not moving, but we just need to update the registration value also. Here in this case that I'm taking, I'm not going with the default x and y values. I'm just taking the player x comma player y minus 15. You can see this minus 10 or 15 depends upon the object height that we are supposed to take. Player minus player dot y minus value. Then when you press the up arrow, look at that. The condition will be executed and it won't move, and it will not cross that line towards that up. The same condition that we are supposed to apply for all the directions. Only the difference is, we just need to change the value of player x and player y depends upon the direction. So for moving upside, I took player y minus Now if it is player, if the direction is down, then player plus y, player y plus, and then left must be player x minus, and right must be player x plus. The same value we can carry. Similarly, that I'm applying a test point if condition for all the four directions. So the first condition is checking variable value, second condition is checking that hit test point. Save it and test it. Now you can see that my object is not moving out of that maze. It is inside that maze. You can see there how beautiful that my object is moving there within the empty gap. Alright, I can move onto the objects and I can move within that empty gap, but it is not crossing that maze. Now, let's save the file once again, and we just need to name the objects inside. We have five different objects there, and I've already named them. I'm just checking the instance name of that each object. They are A1 to A5. When my player is going to hit that A1 to A5 objects, then they should get disappeared. And I just want to count the objects. Once all the objects are disappeared, then maze is supposed to be open. Then my player can go out of the maze. Let us write the same condition inside the same function. But this time that we are not supposed to take that hit test point, that we are supposed to consider hit test object, because we are just checking that hit test between the two different objects. I'm just writing that same condition there. If player mc.hitTest object of A1 mc, then I just wanted to shift the position of the I just wanted to shift the object position, change the object's position. So hit test object is true, then the target object is supposed to move out of the maze. Look at that. It's cool, it is working now. Let's check with all the other objects even. Second object. We just wrote only two conditions there. It works for only two objects. Let's repeat the same condition for all the other three objects also. So player mc.hitTest object and target object. And then we need to update x and y position of the target object. Alright, we have four conditions here for four target objects. Sorry, five conditions and five target objects. Let's save and let's test it now. Perfect, it is working now. So we just need to check with at all the five. Nice, it is working proper. Let's close this, and then it is supposed to count that number of hit test objects. Then based on that count, once I'm done with it, all the hit test objects, and then it is supposed to open the maze. We were already having that small movie clip inside the maze symbol. We just need to shift that symbol to somewhere else. Then from there that my smiley can go out of that maze once all the hits are done. So I just declared one variable there, and my variable name is count. So whenever hit test object done, and then I just wanted to increase that one number of the count. So count plus plus is added to that all the hit test object conditions, and then let us write one more condition here in the same function. If count is double equal to 5, because that my target objects are 5, so based on that we can change the position of the piece which is part of that maze. So if count is double equal to 5, then maze wall MC dot open MC dot visible equal to false. And of course that we are supposed to change the position also. If you invisible it, it may not be visible, but still that will not allow the player to go out. So vice versa, that we are supposed to update that X and Y position also, it is always better. Let's say that OpenMC X is equal to minus 1000 and Y equal to minus 1000. Completely out of the stage. Save it and test it now. And we are supposed to hit all the 5 objects now to open that outer maze line. So 2 more objects to go. So once we hit the last object, which is pineapple there, then maze will be open, and from there that my smiley can go out of that maze. Look at that. Maze is open. From there that my object can go out. You can see there. This is how that it is possible for us to work with that hit test point. Thank you for watching and have a great day.